As we give God glory and honor and praise, we ask you now to remember Brother Joe. He came to church. He had some type of sickness in his body. We're not for sure what it is. I don't think it's the COVID, but I think it's the other type. And so, Lord, we're praying for him that he'll be okay. Asking you to have the hand upon him and his daughter right now. And so, Lord, we're praying for the family. He went home immediately after not feeling well, and so we're praying for him. We're also praying for Nick and Cheryl. They're not feeling so well, so we're praying for them too, God, that you help them today. Help the family recover and others, Lord. We're just praying for everybody. There's just sickness everywhere. But Lord, I'm praying that you keep the rest of us safe.
Yes, Lord.
That you shield us with the shield of faith.
Yes, Lord.
And that you shield us from all the sickness, God.
Yes.
And Lord, that we'll be able to continue to do what we need to do as we go to the house of prayer, but also when we go to our jobs. And Lord, help us do that. In Jesus' mighty name, we thank you. Amen. Sing this over with me. I once was lost in sin. Tell Jesus to so good to be in God's house. Well, this side is kind of filling up a little bit now, praise the Lord. And but we're going to keep praying it fills up all the way. Amen.
Amen.
And you guys got a good head start on this side.
Yeah, we do.
Amen.
Years
Amen.
Being in
the we're just going to we're going to call this the red side and the blue side. Okay, the blue side, the red side.
Oh, yeah.
How about we're all sides? Okay. Yeah. We're just one of these days we'll probably have a contest. It might be kind of fun with it. And we'll see what happens down the road. But maybe Easter. Look at doing something. We will be having an Easter dinner this year, though. Lord willing, we're gonna try, all right? And so we're gonna have an Easter egg hunt for the kids and stuff like that too. And so they really do a good job. Kids, they make sure they get all types of things. So, bless their hearts. I thought about joining the kids this year. No, there's an age limit on that. That means me and you, me and Sue can't participate. We're just too old.
Shucky darn.
But God is good anyway, isn't He? And I just want to say praise the Lord. Well, we do got some announcements today. Let me look at them here real quick. We do have some birthdays. Remember that? Now, most of the birthdays are gone. Praise the Lord. But we do got January 18th at prayer meeting coming up. Between 1 and 2 o'clock here at the church. If you'd like to come join us, feel welcome to do that. Also, January 19th, our Bible study. We're in the book of Revelation. And we're cruising at it. Amen. We're just been cruising, and God has really been blessing us with the Bible study. When I say cruise, half a page each week, all right?
Yeah, we're cruising.
That's right. We're cruising. Because the last Revelation Bible study took me 3 years to do it. So we're cruising this time.
3 years, 5 months, 6 days,
4 months. She remembers. She's so good at it, I'm going to have her teach this one.
No. Probably get through three chapters.
There we go.
Fast track.
So anyway, our Bible study will be this 6:30, this Wednesday night. And remember those, like I said, they're sick. Brother Joe Flora had to go home because he was sick. And had stomach flu virus, that's what he had. So you guys pray for him that he'll be able to overcome that stomach flu, whatever it is.
And don't forget your candles.
And why don't you tell him about your candles,
yeah.
The Lord gave
my
you.
My candles, okay. I was praying one night, and I was asking the Lord, I says, what can I do to help people encourage to get over this COVID and start claiming our health back? And God showed me that, I always do this anyhow, but I have a candle in my front window that it comes on at nighttime and goes off in the morning time. So I'm asking everybody to show the outpouring pride to the Lord that we want a healing for our land. Put a candle in your window at nighttime. Not a real one, okay? We don't want your house to burn down. But put a candle in and show God. Sometimes the Lord wants to see our pride. He hears our pride from our heart. But He sometimes wants to see our outpouring of faith and cry to the Lord. So, if you can do me a favor, you can buy the candles at the dollar store. They're just really cheap little candles. So, do me a favor and help me out with this. And let's show the Lord that we want a healing for our land and our people. We want to claim our lives back. We are tired of this COVID taking our people and getting them sick. So just help me with this, please. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. She's kind of, Lord put that up on her heart. And I said, well, that's kind of biblical. The Bible says that the angel of the Lord was going through the land of Egypt. And the Lord told him, says, I want you to apply the blood of the lamb on the doorpost. And he says, when you apply that blood of the lamb, he said, guess what? My angel will, he will look the other direction. He won't go into your house and cause terrible things to happen. You probably remember the story of Pharaoh,
yeah.
The firstborn of Egypt, every one of that was firstborn, whether it was human or cattle or animal. The Bible says the firstborn would die that night because the hardness of Pharaoh's heart, he wouldn't release the children of Israel. So they wrote a song, "When the blood, when I see the blood, it will pass over us." Amen. The death will overpass us. It will pass by us. And so anyway, there's a song written about it. So I would say, well, this is a good thing. You can go ahead and put the candle in there and show the Lord that you're praying for the land. Can you say amen to that? You're praying for the land for healing and ask the Lord to help you. Well, Lyman's going to come. He's going to share scripture to you today. And so anyway, he'll be receiving the offering today too. God bless you.
Good morning to the Horizon Church of God.
Good morning.
And good morning, Pocatello, Idaho.
Good morning.
Good morning, Pocatello, Idaho.
Yeah, good morning.
And that's home ground for our pastor. That's where he pastored prior to coming to Cokie, Oregon.
Yes.
And so, that's home ground for him. Now last Sunday, after the service, Pam cornered me, and she said, "A gentleman called asking about you." And I said, "Oh," and she said, "Yeah," she gave me his name. "Oh yeah, I remember him. His, actually was his stepdad, and I went to high school together in the city of Portland many years ago." And it brought to my mind that we have a list of those areas that are watching this on Sunday morning and during the week, but it's not a very complete list because Portland was not on that list. And so I thought, well, you know, maybe this morning I can get those of you that are willing, just get a postcard, or I used to call them penny postcards. I don't remember that. I don't know how much postcard it is today. But put your name on there if you want to. What city you live in, and where you're watching us, and drop it in the mail. It doesn't matter where you live. It'd be kind of nice for our pastor to realize how far away and how close also that you folks are receiving these Sunday morning sermons. And so I put that out for you because Portland was not on our list. And Pam, I'm sure I've added it to my list. I'm sure she's added it to hers. And so one of these days, good morning, Floyd. Just put a little bit of a good morning to him. And this morning, we're going to be reading again a scripture on the second coming of Jesus. And we're coming up to almost to a year mark, probably shortly after, maybe even at that time, we will change, because I feel like a full year has been a long time for some of us. And so I'm going to continue for a Sunday or two yet. It's, I thought I would not change. This morning, if you want to stand for the reading of the Word, I'm sure the Lord will bless you and appreciate that. And we will be reading in Revelation chapter 2 again. Well, we've been reading like the last couple of Sundays. And we're going to pick it up this morning at verse 24. And we're going to read two verses. So if you want to follow, fine. This is the words of Jesus. "But unto you I say, and unto the rest of Thyatira, as many as have not this doctrine, and which have not known the depths of Satan, as they speak, I will put upon you none other burden. But that which ye have already hold fast till I come. And Jesus said, he's coming. And so you may be seated if you would. And the ushers, if you would, come forward. While the ushers are coming forward this morning, I thought one more thing. The address on those postcards would be New Horizon Church of God. And the address would be 539 East 8th Street, Coatfield, Oregon 97023. And that would get here. And I kind of look forward to knowing how many folks. Well, good morning, Fernando. It's good to have you help with us this morning. Let us pray over the offerings this morning. Lord, we gather this morning in the name of Jesus, thanking you and praising you for all your goodness to each and every one of us. And Lord, we want to give you thanks for this day. This is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad. And this morning, Lord, we bring to you our worship, giving to you your tithes and our offering. And we ask, Lord, that you receive them from grateful, cheerful giving, Lord. And we ask this all in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen.
Amen.
Trey Jeff.
Well, the Lord is so good.
Amen. Appreciate the Lord. Well, we kind of got a song here, I think you guys like. You feel like tapping your toes, that's okay. You feel like even clapping, that'll be all right. I think you'll like it.
When the Spirit of the Lord is in my heart, God bless you guys. Say that.
We do got children in church. And so there goes the kids.
We're just praising God for that, all right?
Amen.
And appreciate the singers, the pickers, I mean, all of them. How about you guys? Mm-hmm. And appreciate being God's house.
I'll be less froggy next week.
And also, also those that are watching us by our Facebook ministry, we just appreciate that so much. And, like Brother Lyman said, if you feel like it, send us a card. Let us know where you're from, and we'll just salute you for doing that. And he read the address again. Also, our P.O. box is 935 Coquille, Oregon. So either address to get it to us. You get a chance to come and let us know how things are going. If you have a prayer request, send it to us. We'll be more than happy to pray about it. We pray often as we can over all the requests to make sure people are touched by the Lord. And believe it or not, we got a lot of people that, I guess I better unhook this, right? Yeah. We'll be dragging that all over the place. We have a lot of people that do send us texts, emails, all that, want us to know that they're praying for us, but also that we will pray for them. I've seen God heal a lot of people. A lot of people have seen the Lord heal. I've seen him heal people of just about everything, from diabetes to cancer. And no matter what your problem is, God can heal you. Amen.
That's right.
You just got to have faith. Amen. And believe that he's going to do that.
Yes.
And so, anyway, we just want you to know that. Now we're coming to the conclusion of part six on six reasons drawing nigh to God. Or coming closer to God. And I don't know about you, but as Christians, we need to draw closer to God in these last days.
Amen.
If we've ever come to a time in our life where we need God, this is it.
This is it.
This is really it. This is a time we really need God in our life. And we need God's help. We need his healing. We need God to heal the land. How many agree with that?
Amen.
We need God to heal the land. So do like Sister Pruitt, amen. Put a candle in the windows at nighttime. Maybe it'll catch on. Maybe it won't. But we're going to do our part. We're going to believe that when God sees that candle lit, then he's going to do one. He's going to remember us. Amen? And so this is one of the reasons. All right. As we continue today, this will conclude the series on six reasons on drawing near to God. An interesting thought. Why some of us feel such a lack within our lives. It's so important to be open-minded and to become personal with God. Because God loves us and cares about us. And some people draw to the conclusion that nobody really cares, especially like the homeless or the unfortunate. But God truly cares, and it's his desire to see all of us excel and succeed. Can you say amen, Brother Ray? Praise the Lord. Amen. He's saying amen with me, amen. And I'm going to ask him to help me pray, and you too. May the Lord bless this time as we come together. And Lord, I ask you now to just anoint your people today and have your hand up on this, God. And we're just praying that God will continue to remember each and every one, and that his will shall be established and done here today. And Lord, that our prayers will be heard by God Almighty. That God will hear our prayers and hear our petitions and hear us, Lord. Hear our prayers again. We pray that you will help us. I ask you now, let my lips become your lips, my thoughts become your thoughts. Let my mind be the mind of Christ, and that I may take it captive, like the Bible says, and that I will have integrity within my life, and that I'll be holy like God commands me to be. For he said, be holy, for I am holy, saith the Lord. And Lord, I ask you now, let my hands be your hands, my feet be your feet, my arms, my legs, my body, totally submit to thy spirit. And so, Lord, I pray right now that you anoint me this day as we talk about the last part of this series, which is the anointing of God. And Lord, I ask you now to anoint this time as you have earlier, and that I give God glory and God praise. Would you give the Lord a praise offering? Amen. As we continue, God's anointing will be upon us. The sixth issue, the sixth thing that I'm bringing to your attention. Luke's Gospel, chapter 4, verse 18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed. This is the very words of the Lord as he shared this to the people that were in the synagogue that day. And he read a scroll from the book of Isaiah, I believe it was, or one of the Old Testament scrolls, and he read this scripture here into the New Testament scripture. The Bible teaches us. And he said, the Spirit of the Lord is up on me. And this is what we need to understand as we continue this, that without the anointing, guess what? Things will continue the way it always has. We need God's anointing back in this land again. Can you say amen? We need God's anointing in this church today. And you are all anointed. God has anointed all of you in a special way. And I want to share that to you today, how God can use you in these last days. So far, how does God anoint us? By his Spirit. The word Spirit is mentioned in the Bible 456 times, which is relevant to what I'm sharing here today. As we continue, everything is done by his, and by him, and through him, through the Spirit of God. For we find out in Genesis chapter 1, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. But listen here, and the Spirit of God moved up on the face of the waters. Let me tell you, this earth would have never became what it is unless the Spirit of God sanctioned it to be created in this manner. God's Spirit anointed this planet, and when he anointed this planet, he allowed it to become what it is today. And this is what I want you to realize. This is how God anoints us. How he anointed the solar system and created it with his anointing power. The Bible teaches us that God, I don't know if it was by the span of his hands or whatever, but he set it into existence. And the Bible says 6 days he created the heavens and the earth, and on the seventh day he rested. That is such a powerful thing, a powerful message. The anointing of God is so important to be upon each of our lives. It's the anointing that draws your family to Christ. Remember this. It's the Spirit of God anointing you, anointing your family, drawing you closer to him, drawing you nigh. How many feel sometimes all of a sudden you'll be praying about something, you feel this tingling all over your body. You feel like the Spirit of God is all over you. It's the anointing of the Holy Spirit wooing you, covering you. Can you say amen? Amen. And this is what I want you to realize today. As we continue, God's Spirit is transforming. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. So he answered and said to me, this is the word of Zerubbabel. Not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord of hosts. He said, it's not by might nor by power, but he said, I do this by my Spirit. My Spirit hovered over the earth. My Spirit became the creative force of what I see here and what I bid it to do. See, God's Spirit bids. It will do God's bidding. It will fulfill God's word. The Bible teaches us on the day of Pentecost, they were all filled with the Spirit. They were anointed with power up on high because God breathed it up on them. And I want you to understand this as we continue today. God wants to anoint us today. He wants us to be anointed vessels of him. He wants us to fulfill his destiny, his dreams, his visions for us. Not only his visions and his dreams for us, but our visions and our dreams. God wants to anoint us, to give us abilities to do his work. I don't know about you, but I couldn't play the guitar like that unless it was by the Holy Spirit. Do you understand? It's the anointing of God that is upon me that allows me to play musical instruments like this. Not only that, I couldn't preach if it wasn't for the anointing of God's Holy Spirit. Do you understand? I couldn't speak to you. I would be without words. I wouldn't be bold. But because the Spirit anointed me to become bold and emboldened, he gave me the ability to overcome my fears. How many understand that? He gave me the ability to overcome my setbacks. He gave me the ability to continue this transforming power of the Holy Spirit to work in other people's lives. As Jesus said, he said, I've been anointed to set the people free. I've been anointed to heal their bodies. I've been anointed to take those that are depressed and re-encourage them. This is what the anointing of the Spirit does. It woos you. It covers you. Like a mother hen covering its chicks. Can you say amen? I don't know about you, but the other day I was on Facebook and I saw a chicken, and this mother hen, and all of a sudden this little puppy, which was not a chicken, it went over, and guess what the mother hen did? It lifted its wing and put it over the little puppy to keep it warm, to protect it. I don't know about you, but I'm that little puppy, can you say amen, waiting for the Lord to place his wings over me and to hide me in his secret places, can you say amen, or to comfort me in his high and mighty tower, the Bible says. The Lord is our refuge, the Bible says. And so I want you to realize, to give us abilities, he wants us to do life-changing events in our lives. It doesn't matter if you're born first or born last, or you're poor or rich. What matters is that to be available. God's not looking for ability, but he's looking for ability. Can you say, be an availability? Yeah. God's looking for people that are, I will, I do. Show me what to do. But fear will overcome us, and then we'll say, I can't. I'm not sure. How many been there before? I don't know. I'm questioning it. But let me tell you, I can do all things through Christ, as we come to that scripture in a little bit. If you have a dream or vision, he wants to bring it to pass. Can you say amen? Most people are afraid to step out on faith. The reasoning, it's risky. And we're all afraid of failing. And nobody likes to be seen as a failure. Nobody does. Everybody wants to be positive. Everybody wants to be successful. The world is already full of failures, and I don't want to be the next statistic. That's just plain and simple, but God wants us to take, what a chance. He wants us to take a risk on him. He wants us to step out of the boat onto the water like the Apostle Peter did. When he said, is that you, Lord? He said, it is I. He said, if it's really you, allow me to come out to meet you. And he said, come. And he got out of the ship and he began to walk on water, the Bible says. He walked on the water. The other 11 stayed in the boat. They wouldn't get out of it. A lot of us are like that 11. Can you say, man, I'm not getting out. You know, wait, man. You watch. He's going to fall. I'm positive. He's going to fall. He's going to sink. He's going to drown. I mean, know what I'm talking about. I'm going to stay right here where it's safe. Well, you're missing all the fun part. Because Jesus is not in the boat. He's out on the ocean. Can you say amen? He's on the sea. He's on the water. And Peter wanted to be where Jesus is. Can you say amen? Don't you want to be where Jesus is? I want to be where Jesus is.
Yeah.
So he got out of the boat. He began to walk, the Bible says, as the passage of scriptures. And as he walked, he did this and he did that. Boy, this is solid like rock, man. I can't believe this. Look at what happened. That's what we begin to say. I can't believe this. And the Bible says he saw the wind blow and the waves blew at him. And then he took his eyes off of Jesus. And then he began to sink. You know, that's our biggest problem. When the storm of life comes, instead of zeroing in on Jesus, we zero in on everything that's resisting us. How many done that before? Resist. How many focused on the problem and not the problem solver?
Mm-hmm.
We all have. We're all guilty of that, focusing on the problem and not the problem solver. And that's where you and I come in. Don't put your eyes on the world. The world will fail you, but God will keep you sink with him. Can you say amen? He will keep you on and above the water. This is what I want you to realize. Come out of our boxes, away from our four walls, and see the world of faith. Can you say amen? How many gotten out of your four walls? Can you say amen? How many beginning to experience the world of faith again? And that's why we're here at church today. Can you say amen? Lastly, God's plan, and it includes us. Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You know, I can do it because he did it. Come on now. If he can heal people, guess what? You can do the same thing in his name. If Jesus healed all manner of diseases, all manner of sicknesses, you can do the same thing in the name of Jesus. But you have to step out of your four walls of doubt into the world of faith again. Can you say amen? You have to come out of your four walls of doubt where it's safe, where you feel secure. But guess what? It's not taking a risk. God sometimes wants you to take a risk. He wants you to become emboldened. He wants you to become anointed. He wants you to step out of your shell. Come to him. And he'll show you what he wants you to do and to fulfill your life dream. God wants to fulfill your life dreams. He wants to fulfill your visions. But you must be willing to take a risk. Because guess what? Old Satan's going to do everything he can to make sure your plans fail. But God will do everything he can to make sure they succeed. Right? Some of you have been dreaming about doing wonderful things for the Lord. Begin the process of praying to God and say, God, I feel led to do this. Anoint me to do this, Lord. Anoint me. And God will do that. He will bring the anointing power of the Holy Spirit into your life where you can be fulfillment. And you will fulfill God's plan for you in life. Sometimes you have that dream of life. Sometimes you feel like doing something for the Lord.
Amen.
But other things hold you back because you're afraid. You're afraid, well, if I do it, I'm going to fail. People are going to laugh at me. You know how many times I've been laughed at? You know how many times I've been told I was going to be a failure? I can write books on it. Family is the worst ones. Oh, this is just a fad with him. It won't last that long. Well, it's been going 50 years now. Can you say amen? 50 years ago, I became a Christian. 50 years ago, I started preaching. 50 years ago, I gave my heart to Jesus. 50 years ago, God emboldened me. I used to be so shy. I was afraid to ask a girl on a date. That's how shy I was. How many been there before? I'm afraid I was going to be turned down. One girl got kind of upset at me. She found out I got married. She said, well, why didn't you ask me out? I would have went out with you. I said, I didn't. Yeah, I didn't know. You know, it's one of those things. I was 19, 20 years old. But I want you to know that we're all made up. We're human. And the human thing is we fail. We're afraid to speak up. We're afraid to say things. We're afraid. And so when I met Sister Pruitt, I says, I got over that real quick. When God filled me with the Spirit and anointed me, I looked at her one day and said, you want to get married? She said, no. Turned me down once. Her mom and dad came and got me. He said, because she don't like you doesn't mean we don't. I said, all right. So I started hanging around Billy and Verna May. That was her name. His name was Bill and her name was Verna, actually. And so anyway, I'd go fishing with them. And Margie, she'd see my old Rambler out there. 66 Rambler. Oh, no, 64 oh, Rambler. Goodness. Oh, my gosh. 60, I should have kept that thing. 64 Rambler. She said, oh, God, please don't let him be there. Please don't let him be there. She used to pray. Please don't let him be there, God. And she'd come over the railroad track. Oh, God, he's there. He's there. Finally, we got started getting around each other a little bit more. I said, why get married? No. She rubbed me off again. Finally, the third time, she started hanging around me. Well, guess what? Bill and Vernon came back and got me again. He said, because Margie don't like you doesn't mean we don't. I said, well, I don't want to be intrusive, you know. No, you're not. You just come. You just stay at our home. We love you. And I was driving back and forth to Portland because open heart surgery, how do you remember those days? It was kind of a pioneer type of medical procedure back in 1975, I think it was, 74, 75. And so I would take him up forth to Portland for his surgery and for all those other things. And so I got to really know him really well. Well, finally, Margie started hanging around me again. Started dating me again. I said, listen, I'm not going to keep asking you. I said, if you're going to marry me, and let's get it done and get over with it. She said, okay, I'll marry you. I says, thank God. Man, I hurried that wedding up as fast as I could because I didn't want her to turn me down or run me off again. How many know what I'm talking about? And so anyway, we've been married now almost 47 years. Yeah, we got married again. I was 19, just turned 19, and she was 17. This is how young we were. It can happen. Young people can get married and stay together. Yes, it works. The world says don't do it. Don't get married until you're 30, 40, or 50, or 60, or 70, or whatever. Well, you missed out on a lot of good things. I want you to know that. So it's important to be what? Go with the Spirit as he moves in your life. Amen. Well, he anointed our marriage, and guess what? We've been pastoring ever since. All because the anointing of the Spirit. The Spirit laid it all out. The Bible says that God has planned the footsteps of your life. He has planned it all out for you. And so I want you to realize that. Therefore, encourage one another, build each other up, just as in fact you're doing. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. God has a plan and it includes all of us. You know, God has called some of you to be teachers. He's really anointed you, but you're kind of afraid. You're kind of afraid to do it. You're afraid, well, I don't know the Bible that much. How much of the Bible did I know when I was 15? Zilch.
Yeah, me too.
And the pastor asked me one Wednesday night, you want to preach? I says, I don't know how. Well, here, get a verse and read it and talk about it. So I did. He launched me right out, man. I just, a little bit over 15 years of age, I said, I've never done this before, but I don't know how long I could do it. I think I lasted 5 minutes, and I repeated myself the whole time. Excuse me. I did. I repeated myself the whole time, and I told the pastor, I said, I think I bombed it. He said, no, you didn't. He said, you said what was that God laid upon your heart. And he said, the Bible says that your word will go out, and guess what? It will not come back vain. Mm-hmm. He said, it will do its purpose. Yes. Yeah. Well, the next time, I lasted 7 minutes. Did he say amen? Then I lasted 15 minutes. And then I got a little bit older, 16 years old, and they asked me to preach the fellowship meeting. I got to preach to about 150, 200 people that day. And man, the Lord anointed me, and I was preaching from everything on, from cigarettes to Pepsi Cola. Can you say amen? I made those pastors so mad at me, they're about ready to run me out of that church. One pastor told me, he said, I can tell that Brother Vernon is going to be what we call a holiness preacher. Mm-hmm. And that's what I became. And so I want you to know, I would have never done it unless my pastor, what? Encouraged me to do it. Mm-hmm. Encouraged me. Can you say amen? Yeah. So I want you to realize that. Somebody might come to you and they said, would you like to, what do you think about doing this or doing this in the church? Your eyes get bigger. I'm afraid. Yeah, that's natural. That's natural to be afraid. It happened to all of us. Until you get old like me and it don't matter. You just go with the flow. Can you say that? Yeah. But I'll be honest with you, I couldn't preach now if it wasn't for the anointing. I wouldn't be able to talk. I wouldn't be able to say anything. I wouldn't be able to articulate anything if I do it anyway. Do you understand? I always thought I was a dumb hillbilly. How many know what I'm talking about? An Okie from the Skokie. How many know what I'm talking about? How many identify with that song?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And this is what I want you to realize. I can do all things through Christ who what strengthens me. I can do all things through Christ who what anoints me. I can do it through Jesus Christ because he anointed me to do it. Whether it's leading singing or singing specials or reading a verse of scripture, or teaching a Sunday school class, or a Bible study, God has anointed you to do the work. And guess what? His word will not come back void. It will do its very purpose, the Bible says. Whether it's just a few words or a few thousand words, the word of the Lord will still go forth. Can you say amen? Six rewards of drawing near to what? God. Prayer. Establishing your faith. Can you say amen? And now we come to this part here, anointing. God's anointing. What would it be if it wasn't for the anointing of the Spirit? How would this world conduct itself? I don't know about you, but not everybody can be a president unless God anoints him to do it. Or a leader. Whether we like that leader or not, God anoints them. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Whether it's a king or a queen, God anoints those leaders. Not everybody can be a king unless they're anointed. The Bible says before David became a king, he was a shepherd. Samuel went to the house of Jesse. God told him to go there. And he said, I will anoint the next king who will take Saul's place. So Jesse brought all his sons out, and he saw the first one, and all of a sudden he said, that must be the Lord's chosen. And the Spirit said, no, it's not. It's not him. And it went to the second one, it's not him. Finally went to all of them, and God rejected every one of the sons, except the last one. He said, do you got any more sons? He said, yeah, I got this runt of a bunch. He's just a pain in the neck. I put him out on sheep patrol because he's a dirty rascal. I'm adding italics. He's just a dirty, he's a mean kid. How many ever had a mean brother in your family? I know I was the one. I was the one. I'd pull on my sister's hair. I'd do some crazy things. My oldest sister used to call me a demon. He's a demon, Mama. He's a demon. How many ever been called a demon before? Well, I hope you haven't, but I was. Well, anyway, Samuel said, do you got any other sons? He said, yeah, I got this last one. He's tending the sheep. Would you sit for him to come? And when he came in, the Lord said, that is him. He will become the next king.
Yeah.
Take the oil and anoint him. He would have never been king unless what? Until he was anointed. The preacher had to anoint him with oil. He took a cruse of oil and poured it over him. This is how they anointed you in that day. The anointing represented the Spirit as this jar of olive oil was poured over the top of him. It went down his head, down his whole body, and covered him, like the Holy Spirit does today when it anoints you. It completely covers you, the anointing Spirit does, and anoints you for the duty, for the job, or the task at hand. That very moment, God's Spirit entered into David, and God began to what? Exalt him. He gave him so great abilities, brother. These are the abilities he gave him. One time, this lion grabbed a hold of the sheep, and he ran and grabbed that thing by the beard and jerked it and killed that thing with his bare hands. Can you imagine when the Spirit came upon him, he became very strong and powerful. Not only that, but when he went into the armies, fight the Philistines, the Spirit of the Lord would come on him like Samson, and he would kill the Philistines left and right. That's where they got that slogan. Saul killed his thousands, but David killed his 10,000s.
Yeah.
He became so gifted in the art of warfare that everyone feared him. Everybody feared him. Even Saul himself began to fear him. This is what God will do. When God gives you a gift, he will make it so powerful that the enemy will constantly look at ways to destroy you. Constantly. So it's important that you stay prayed through, prayed up, and full of the victory. Can you say amen? Would you bow your head with me today? Father, thank you for allowing us to come together on this last part of the anointing of the power of the Spirit of the Lord. And Lord, I am so thankful for your anointing, because without it, I wouldn't be able to do anything or accomplish anything in your name. But because of it, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And so, Father, I pray for these today, for the anointing. I pray for these that have a calling on their life, God. I don't know what their callings are, but you do, Lord. And so I pray for them, God. I pray that you help them, God.
Amen.
Minister to them. And that your Spirit will be upon them. I pray for their bodies. I pray for their spirit and their souls. I pray for them. I pray for them. I pray for them in Jesus' wonderful, wonderful name. With every head bowed, eyes closed. Maybe there's someone here today who feels a calling in your life. You feel like God has called you to do something. Why don't you come up and I'll anoint you. I'll anoint you with oil that God will fulfill that. Yeah, whatever you like to do. Whatever you like to do. If you want to come up for prayer, I'll pray for you. But I'm praying for these today that you feel like God is leading you to do something. Come, let me pray for you today. Let me pray for you. Here comes someone. Lord, right now, in Jesus' name, I pray over this brother, God, that you call him, that you anointed him to do something. Lord, you know what this is. And Lord, I'm praying for him today. I'm praying for him today, God, that you anoint him, God. Pour out your spirit upon him, oh God. Pour it upon him, Lord, as we magnify and glorify you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, I speak faith into his life. I speak it into his life that he will stand on the Lord, that he will stand on that rock of Jesus Christ. That high rock of the Lord. Right now, in Jesus' name, I pray over him. Anoint him. Endue him with power of the Lord upon high. I thank you right now, in Jesus' name. May I love the Spirit of God. Amen. Someone else. God is calling you to do something. I want to pray for you. There we go. I want to pray for you that God will open the door for you. Open it up and use you. Amen. Here we go. Lord, I pray over this sister, God, that you anoint her now, God. Anoint her in Jesus' name. Anoint her as the Spirit will move upon her. Anoint her and strengthen her. Strengthen her with the scriptures. Strengthen her in her prayer life. Strengthen her with her gifts, oh God. I anoint you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I speak mysteries and wisdom and knowledge. I speak it into you. I speak it into you, the marvelous fans of the Lord. I speak this into you. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you today. Amen. I thank the Lord. Pray about what God wants you to do. Anyone else, I will pray for you today. I will anoint you that God will use you, that you will surrender yourself completely to him. Don't you want to surrender to him? Don't you want to submit to him?
Yeah.
Don't you want him to have an impact in your life? Come, let me pray with you. I feel like there's another one. I feel it. And maybe two. The Lord is saying to me. He said, there's two more. He said, come, that I may anoint you, and that God will pour out his Spirit upon you. Oh God, right now, I pray over this one, God. In Jesus' name, I speak healing and miracles into her life, God. I speak anointing into her life. God, open the doors for her. Use her for God's glory. Use her. Lord, give her the wisdom of the scriptures. Give her the wisdom of prayer. Give it to her, God. As you move upon Hannah, God, move upon her. As you use Rachel, use her. Lord, as you use Ruth, the Moabitess, oh God, use this daughter of yours, oh God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. That's all right. Someone else. I feel there's another one. God wants to use you. God wants you to glorify him with your gifts. God wants to use you mightily in these last days. God wants to use you. He said, don't hold back. He He said, I'll walk with you. I will guide you, says the Lord. I will guide you. I have anointing oil. Don't you feel it tugging on you? Right now, I just feel it's tugging you. It's pulling you. It's like a hook pulling you. I know it because it did it to me before I was called. I felt the Spirit pulling me, wanting me to release and allow it to have its way in my life. That's the problem. We don't want to give up. But God wants us to give it up and let Him have you completely, 104%. Aren't you tired of living in fear? Aren't you tired of living in fear? For much is given, much is required. All right, Lord, I pray over him, God. Anoint him, God. Use him, God. Use him. Use him. Oh, God, touch his life. Touch him, God. Help him, God. Help him. Help him right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, give him wisdom. Give him the fullness of the Spirit. Give him the fullness of the Spirit, oh, God. Dwell in him, oh, God. Lord, heal his heart right now. Heal his mind. Heal. 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 Heal in Jesus' name. Heal him. All right. Anyone else? You feel led of the Lord. I am anointed now. Let me anoint you. This oil is holy oil. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the name. I don't know. I still sense there's someone else. Man, I sense it. And I'm being truthful with you. I'm right. Because the Spirit is telling me this. The Spirit is telling me this. Only you and the Lord. Between you and the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Trust the Lord, the Bible teaches us. Allow him to have his way in your life. Some of you have been coming. The reason you're coming is because you're hungry. You want more than the normal. Hallelujah. You want more than what you've been saying. There is much more to come, the Spirit says. He said, this is just the beginning for you. He said, great and mighty and powerful things are going to happen. And he says, you're going to just be amazed when these things happen, says the Lord. You're going to be amazed.
Praise God.
He said, for my Spirit shall be poured out in the last days.
Amen.
And will be poured out upon all flesh.
In the rain, Lord.
He said, my young men will see visions, and my old men will dream dreams. He said, my Spirit will pour up on your sons and your daughters before the great day of the Lord takes place. I believe a great revival is coming through the land, and you're all going to be part of it. Amen. Would you stand with me? I didn't mean to keep you so long. Who would have gave me 5 more minutes, though? Would you raise your hand? 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Praise God, I could have went on another hour.
Amen.
Another an hour. I should ask you before I had to stand. You're a rotten pastor. I've been called that and a heathen. May the Lord bless us. Father, thank you for being here with us today. I feel such a wonderful spirit of the Lord. And a transforming spirit, a healing spirit. Father, I pray you keep every one of them safe. That none of them will become sick at all. Because this is your power, God. This is your holiness.
Amen.
Your power.
Amen.
And it will uphold us and teach us as we dwell in the presence of the Most High. Amen. Father, go with us. Bring us back to the appointed time. In that wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. God bless you guys. Thanks for coming.